Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to a short video presentation from the Science and Life project about the symbolic and the real identity of the human being. To begin with, imagine reality as one big picture or photo you would have in front of you. What language does, expressed in a very simple way, is defining a jigsaw puzzle on this picture. Language cuts certain pieces out of this picture in a certain way and gives them a name. It creates objects and separates them from all the others. In the first instance, you can only talk about these pieces and nothing else. The meanings of linguistic expressions or names are, in this case, these pieces of reality, the pieces as defined by the puzzle. Of course, we have done here a very first naive approximation to language and meanings. Actually, very sophisticated theories about language and reality exist, but for our purposes, it suffices to give a general idea. Returning to our language puzzle, the first thing to note is that you don't choose the way the puzzle is made. You don't configure it. The forms, the edges, and the contents of these pieces are imposed on you by society, by education, social interactions, etc. So, who are you for yourself and for society? A being defined in and through language, that is, a linguistic description, a linguistic construction of yourself and of others. What you and society express in language that you are is your symbolic identity. If you are a woman or a man or a teacher, an engineer, a husband, a wife, a mother, a father, and so on. That each of these words corresponds to certain pieces of the puzzle, the meanings of which you don't create. They were predetermined and imposed on you. Do these conventional meanings really describe your experienced identity? If you are a wife or a father or a friend, do you feel correctly described by this conventional meaning? Or do you experience that these words don't really capture what you are? That you are a different meaning, for which there are simply no words? Would you need to create a private language, a language of your own, made by you, to catch your essence? Each of these labels used to describe you contains and implies other labels and their meanings. Social roles and behaviors are fixed by them, and so are you. You are a conventionally fixed being. Do you really feel free? Do you really feel that this is you? Language is a jail, and at the same time, the only way to escape from it, due to the incredible feature of language of being capable to talk about itself, to change itself. So, learn about language and its powerful structures, think and read about language, analyze language. This will be the only way to free yourself and to break out of the prison of language. The conflicts that arise from this duality of the symbolic self and the experienced self are very complex by their nature. But their comprehension and understanding can be a very powerful tool to redefine and find unity inside yourself. This fascinating topic is included in the educational program of the Science Alive project. Well, thank you for your attention.